Come away with me. Now we're alright. You show. Come away with me. Come away.
Thank you. I'd like to welcome all gathered in attendance today. We are here to witness the union of Jerry Greenwell and Alicia Ritchie in holy matrimony. So thank you for coming to witness this and partake in the happiness that they are sharing. I will be reading some scripture here pretty soon, but all of the scripture will be based on what the Bible has to say about oneness. Oneness with God, oneness with each other, which is a key ingredient to the happiness that you will be sharing in your marriage. In John 17:20, it says this, "I do not pray for these alone, but for those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. And they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And the glory which you gave me, I have given them, that they may be one, just as we are one, I in them, and you in me. And they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them as you have loved me." In that scripture there, it says, "and that the world may know that you have sent me," referring back to the oneness that they share. And in your marriage, the oneness that you have with each other, the cooperation, the coordination, your activities, all being of one mind and one purpose there, will guide you and direct your steps to have a wonderful, loving relationship. And another scriptural example of oneness and sacrifice is also found in Acts 4:32, where it says, "Now the multitude of those who believed were of one heart and one soul. Neither did anyone say that any of the things he possessed was his own, but they all had things in common. And with great power the apostles gave witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Nor was there anyone among them who lacked, for all who were possessors of lands and houses, sold them and brought the proceeds of the things that were sold, and they laid them at the apostles' feet, and they distributed to each one as they had need." So as it is in this case, also in your marriage, there the sacrifices that you make for the oneness, the completeness, will be of great price to you and to each other. For the oneness, there is oftentimes a need to have separate roles in order to complete that oneness. An example for that would be found in Ephesians 5:22, where it says, "Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is head of the wife, as also Christ is head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything." Now, husband, you have a great responsibility and role as well. It goes on to say, "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church." Now, this is a small paragraph, but with great significance on how to love your wife. And as you go through marriage, you will learn as you go how to continue to fulfill this role here. It won't happen overnight, but it is an ongoing process of learning to be the type of husband you should be. And so for you, Alicia, for you to learn how to be the best wife that you can be. In Ecclesiastes 4:9, it says this, that two are better than one, and because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift the other. But woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help. Again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? And though one might prevail against another, two will withstand one. A three-fourth cord is not easily broken. And so it is for you as you bind yourself together to be one, one in mind, one in purpose, one in spirit, and also one with God being the third cord in your marriage, that there is nothing that will be too difficult for you to conquer in your marriage if you will be one with each other and also one with God. In Mark 2, for this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Jerry and Alicia, today you pledge your love before family and friends. You choose from this day forward to travel together on a lifelong journey as husband and wife. Allow the love that brought you here today to serve as your guide along this path. Love fosters kindness and patience and wisdom. Keep these things for each other always, and you will build a home upon stable ground, able to withstand even the worst of storms. And there will be storms in your life that will come about. Some small, and hopefully not too many that are great. But there will be storms that you will need to weather. But it will be the love that you have with each other and for each other that will enable you to weather these storms and not to lose heart, not to lose sight or purpose, but will strengthen you at the time when you need it most during those storms. For anyone can be married when everything is going perfectly smooth. But it is when difficult times assail you that the love that you have for each other will stand the test of time and will create strength within your marriage and longevity. Now, it is time for the vows in your marriage. It's a small statement, but one that will take a lot of work to make this vow work. So, Jerry, would you repeat after me? I, Jerry, do take you, Alicia, to be my lawful wedded wife.
I, Jerry, do take you, Alicia, to be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part. Alicia, would you repeat after me? I, Alicia, do take you, Jerry, to be my lawfully wedded husband.
I, Alicia, do take you, Jerry, to be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Now the rings that you're going to exchange I would like to say something about those rings before you exchange those rings. Now comes the time for the exchanging of rings. The ring has long been a symbol of love between two people. As the ring is a continuous circle without end, it reminds us that our love should be continuous and without end. The ring is often made of precious metal and minerals, which reminds us that the union of husband and wife is something to be sought after and treasured when found. The fact that the ring is hollow in the middle and wraps around a finger should remind us that the love should encircle and protect this couple. And there is a verse in Proverbs that says, "He who finds a wife finds a..." Pledge my love to you.
With this ring, I pledge my love.
To be committed to you in sickness and in health.
Be committed to you in sickness and in health.
In prosperity and adversity.
In prosperity and adversity.
From this day forward and for as long as I shall live.
From this day forward and for as long as I shall live.
Now repeat after me, Jerry. Alicia, would you repeat after me? With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
To be committed to you in sickness and in health.
In prosperity and adversity.
In prosperity and adversity.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And for as long as I shall live.
For as long as I shall live. Relation, would you repeat after me this now? As I place this ring on your finger.
As I place this ring on your finger.
It will remind me of my commitment to love.
It will remind me of my commitment to love.
Honor and be the best wife I can be to you. Now that you've exchanged vows to each other and exchanged rings as a token of your love for each other, before these witnesses, before God, I now pronounce you to be husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jerry Greenwell.
Thank you. think that's good.